Okay, let's take a few numericals now. Write down the you have the measurement of voltage and current. Voltage is measured as 100 plus minus 5 volts. Okay, and current is measured as 10 plus minus 0.2 ampere. Okay, you need to find the error in the resistance. Find the error in the calculated resistance. Have you done derivatives? Not yet.
I know some, like, no, we.
No, knowing is different before, but it is not done in CENTUM right now.
We did it in 10th.
Okay, so when you are done with derivative, then you will come to understand there. Using derivative, all of these things can be done easily. You can take log both sides and differentiate. When you take log, the variable goes in denominator and delta comes in the numerator. Okay, but then right now, till you have not done derivative, we'll not do it right now. We'll do it later on. Solve this question. 7-0?
Yes, sir.
It cannot be 7-0 because
0.07.
What is the true value of resistance? 10 by 10 or 100 by 10? 10. So any error more than 10 is something wrong.
It's 0.07.
Yeah.
0.07?
Yeah.
So
10.07.
No. 0.7 is correct.
Verified
absolute. Yes.
So that's
absolute is point. Absolute only. I have asked. What is the, when I say what is the error, you have to calculate absolute error. If I am asking a relative error, I will specify what is the relative error. Relative error is 0.07. How? You remember the formula for resistance? Ratio between voltage and current. All of you remember, na? So delta R by R is equal to delta V by V plus delta I by I. Okay? What is delta V by V and delta I by I? Delta V is how much? Error in V? 5? 5 by 100. Plus 0.2 by 10 or 2 by 100. So this is 7 by 100. So percentage error is 7% in the measurement of resistance. Okay, and the value of R is 10, 100 by 10. True value is 10. So error will be 10 into 7 by 100. So 0.7. 0.7 ohm is the absolute error. Okay, do you remember how to find the equivalent resistance if resistances are connected in parallel? What is that? 1 by R equivalent is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2. Now if I ask you to find out the error in R equivalent, given error in R1 and R2, will you be able to?
Yes, sir. R1, R2 by R1.
We have not done this kind of thing, right? We have only done multiplication, addition, and exponents.
You can do that, yeah.
But this is summation of inverse of that.
R1, R2 by R1 plus R1.
Okay, so R equivalent is, you are saying R1, R2 divided by R1, R2. Then what you will do? This is multiplication and division together. Multiplication, division and addition together.
So
we have not done that. We only have done only addition, only subtraction. And you can have multiplication, division together and addition, subtraction together. But you can't have on the same expression summation as well as multiplication. Okay? That we have not done. But it doesn't mean that it will not have error. There is an expression for this also. The way you find expression is using help of derivative. Okay, in your book they have directly given the expression, they have told that in this situation the error formula is this. Okay, let me just quickly tell you how they have got it. Those who know the derivative can appreciate, but then you don't need to know. I'm just telling you how it is coming. If you take derivative, differentiate it with respect to any variable, let's say variable is x. If you differentiate 1 by r equivalent, you'll have 1 by r equivalent for minus 1 by r equivalent square into dr equivalent by dx is equal to minus 1 by r1 square dr1 by dx minus 1 by r2 square dr2 by dx. Okay, this dx dx is gone.
This is
so
minus.
Minus is also gone. So you have dr equivalent by r equivalent square is equal to dr1 by r1 square plus dr2 by r2 square. So if your error is very small, let's say error is delta r, you can write dr as delta r. If it is small, then you can say that delta r equivalent by r equivalent square is equal to delta r1 by r1 square plus delta r2 by r2 square. Okay, actually in physics there will be lot of times, you know, that we have to come back to the same chapter after some time if you are preparing for JEE, because these kind of thing you will not understand if you don't know what is the derivative. So when you learn derivative, we'll come back to this chapter a little bit, talk about this kind of scenario, and then this chapter is done. Similarly, when we do kinematics, you need to know what is integral calculus and all those things that will come up. Okay, so once you are done with integral calculus basics of it, we have to again come back on kinematics and do it. Okay, so right now, how many have you understood this?
So, I got it, but
so you
we
can
generally don't cancel out dx dx.
Yeah, I know.
Cancel.
I didn't know that you could do that.
Why not?
Because only integration we treat d something as
as a block, right?
What
you don't.
What is drx by dx? Dividing drx divided by dx. Yes or no? Why can't you cancel dx?
But it's like cancelling a multiplication sign. If you have 2 into 3 is 3 into 4, it's like cancelling multiplication. It's
an what you said, 2 into 3 is equal to 3 into 4, you're saying.
It's like cancelling out the two multiplication signs. It's an operator, it's not exactly a variable.
First of all, these are not two equal.
No, I mean, if you have something like that.
Huh?
So if
you can do
3
into
2.
Are you saying operator?
Yeah.
It is operator. No, it is not an operator. It is simply, what is happening here is this. You are changing x little bit.
Yeah.
How much? Dx. Dx is change in x.
Yeah.
If you change x by dx amount, how much change r has? Which is dr. Derivative is simply a ratio of change in r with change in x. That's all. Okay? Derivative is a method. That's all. Okay? Why do you think dx square by dx is 2x? It is derived. Okay? It is derived like that. Okay? When this delta x tends to 0, it becomes 2x automatically. I hope I am clear. If you change x little bit, what will x square become? X plus delta x, x plus minus delta x, the whole square. This is what it will become. Okay, so if delta x is tending to 0, then this will tend towards, you can take x square outside, it will become 1 plus minus delta x by x, the whole square, then binomial approximation, it will become 1 plus minus 2 delta x by x, only when delta x is very small. Delta x is close to dx, let's say. Okay, so change in x square is how much? Change in x square is how much? It has become x square plus minus 2x dx, that's all, right?
Yeah.
The change in x square is this, 2x dx. If you divide it from dx, it becomes 2x. So it's not operator. Derivative is a method. I mean, even though you can call it loosely an operator, but this operator is not same as multiplication sign. Multiplication is a sign. Okay? But then of course, if 2 into 3 is equal to, what it will be equal to? 1 into 6. Then you can't cancel 1 into 2. Okay? Anyways, we can discuss all this later on. Right now, you have less understanding of calculus. But definitely you can cancel out dx like that. Alright guys, next question. Next question. Please focus here. Okay, time period of oscillation of a pendulum. You know what it is? T is equal to
2 pi under root L by G.
Okay, this is the formula. The measured value of length is 20.0. Measured value of length is 20.0 centimeter. Okay? It is known to 1 mm accuracy. What does it mean? 1 mm accuracy. It means that the random error is 1 mm. You don't know whether it is plus 1 mm, minus 1 mm, plus 0.5 mm, minus 0.5 mm, but whatever it is, it fluctuates plus minus 1 mm. So length is 20.0 centimeter, known to 1 mm accuracy, and time for 100 oscillation. Time for 100 oscillation is found to be 90 seconds. It is no, this time is calculated using a wristwatch of 1 second accuracy. Accuracy is 1 second. So definitely you can't calculate the one time period's time. With accuracy of 1 second, I cannot calculate less than 1 second. Right? So that is why I'm calculating time for 100 oscillation. Understood? So this is the scenario. You need to find out the accuracy. You need to find accuracy in determination of G. When I say accuracy, it also means that I am asking you to find the error. Okay? Finding accuracy and finding errors, same meaning. Although they are opposite. The hint is the formula is for one oscillation and formula is for time period. Should I do it?
So you can leave pi as pi, right?
Pi as pi, but pi square is 10, roughly. Remember this, pi square is 10, it helps. But the error in pi is 0.
Yeah.
It's a constant. Okay, should I do it now? Even tell me percentage error or any error, whatever you
want.
Root will not come. If you're getting root, something wrong. Done? How much?
No, 1 by 400 into 91
square and all your thing. Okay, should I do it now?
Yes.
First of all, you need to write it in a form of y is equal to function of whatever the measured quantity. For what you are calculating the error? Getting error for the G. What are the quantities you are measuring? T and L. So bring G this side and T and L on the right hand side. Modify the expression. Have you done that? So you will get T square equal to 4 pi square L by G. So G will be what? 4 pi square L by T square. This is what you will get. But the problem is that this is the equation for 1 time period. For 100 time period, what will be the equation? 100 times. Okay, 100 T should be equal to 200 pi L by G. You are not measuring T, you are measuring 100 times T. Okay, so you modify the formula by writing this as T 100. Okay, please ignore this. First, you modify the formula in terms of what you are measuring. Understood? You are measuring 100 times of T. You are not measuring T. All of you understood? So now you get the value of T in terms of T 100.
Time for one oscillation is 9/10 of a second.
No, don't do that.
Because then
you are not measuring 1/10 of the time period. You are measuring the time period of 100 oscillation. You should write in terms of what you are measuring. I can understand your feelings, but that's not how it is done. Okay? You should write the, what is this error? This error of 1 second is on the error of 100 oscillations reading. So your variable should be variable for 100 oscillation. Then only you can use the error as 1 second. Okay? So T 100 is 200 pi under root L by G. So T 100 square is equal to, let's say, 200 pi square into L by G. So G will become equal to 200 pi the whole square L by T 100 square. Now, how to find the error in G? This is a division of two measured quantities. So relative error in G will be what? Delta G by G will be equal to delta of 200 pi square, which is what?
Zero.
So error in this is zero. So this is gone. Then this is equal to delta L by L. Then
2 delta T
plus 2 delta T 100 divided by T 100. Understood? Okay.
Is it 1.61 bar, sir?
No, at this stage I should not say it is wrong. Let me solve it. Okay, so delta G by G will be what? Delta G by G. How much is delta L?
So
1
by
10. 1 mm?
Yeah.
Delta L is 1 mm, which is 0.1 centimeter.
Yeah.
Both units should be same. Delta L and L, both units should be same.
Yeah.
So 0.1 divided by 20. You can convert both into meters also. It is fine. Again, it will be same itself. Plus 2 times what? Delta T is how much?
1.
1 second of accuracy divided by 90. T 100 is 90. Understood? Okay, so when you substitute all of this, you will get 0.032.
Yeah.
So the percentage error is 3%. You discard the third decimal point. It can't be more accurate than the reading itself. Okay? Any doubt here? These are your NCERT level question. This is from your NCERT solid exercise.
Wait, so we were supposed to find relative.
I thought we had to find delta G.
Delta G will be G into 0.03, no?
Yeah, that will be complicated.
No, G is 10.
But how can you...
You use, okay? The true value of G is close to 10, or it will be given. If it is not given, you can...
I thought we should calculate from
but
that.
Did you get 0.03? You have to anyway calculate.
For relative, I got that.
You got that.
Oh, so right. Yeah, even I got 0.03, but then I thought for G we're gonna have to substitute everything there.
G is always 10.
No, but shouldn't
this
be, why should
yeah,
it
you
be
can calculate
down
G from here. You
yeah.
can calculate
yeah,
G.
Can,
you can put this as 90. You can put L as 20 cm. You'll get the value of G.
Yes.
So
from
it's 8 into 10 to the power 4 divided by 81.
Then multiply G
okay.
with that. No.
So
understood.
That was.
Oh, it's weird.
Terrible.
Right. So they mean to say
0.1.
Relative error. But if you have to find the absolute error, first you have to calculate G from this expression by stop talking. First you have to substitute the value of 100 times T, which is 90 seconds over here, and L as 0.2 meters over here to get the value of G. And then that you use here to get delta G. Okay?